Do I have Jerry Lynn on the line?
Yes, you do.
Hi, Jerry. It's nice to be able to talk with you.
Hey, sorry I'm a little late.
I was saying I'm beginning to wonder. I thought it was going to be three times the charm, but you pulled it out. So what did you get a chance to move date night to Wednesday?
No, we're in the middle of it.
Wow, well, hopefully it's the beginning part of the date night and not the end part, because I don't know if my viewers want to be hearing that on the phone.
Oh, no, it's just sort of the middle.
Hey, that's kind of how I like it as well, too. Well, Jerry, you're an awesome guy. I've had a chance to, I guess, follow your career a little bit. And the interesting thing is, as some wrestling fans obviously know, there's all these different promotions out there. The big ones were WCW, WWE, TNA, and you've had a chance to work for all of them, but now you're actually at Ring of Honor. So what is it like to work with all those different federations and then now to wind up at Ring of Honor?
But the scary part is it's gone by so fast since this March started my 21st year in wrestling. And it's just been an amazing and, well, fun ride. But I'm so glad I'm at Ring of Honor now, because it's kind of rejuvenated my career and got me to create some new goals, which is hard to do after this many years.
That is true. What is one of your goals? Because you are are you still the current Ring of Honor heavyweight champion?
Yes. Anytime you start with a new company, that is your goal, is to climb that ladder and get to the top. So that was one goal I was able to achieve.
Well, that is awesome. And one of the interesting things for some that may not really follow wrestling too much, but actually watched the movie The Wrestler, the Ring of Honor was very big into that movie. There was certainly brand images of Ring of Honor. How did that come about? Were you at Ring of Honor at the time? And there is some semblance, I don't know if anyone's told you, of I guess, how you look compared to the Mickey Rourke character.
Yeah, the first time I saw the poster, I about fell out of my chair. But luckily his head was down, because I hope I don't look as old as he did in that movie. But no, I wasn't with Ring of Honor when they did the movie, but I saw the movie, and yeah, a lot of the guys had quite a few cameos in it.
Yeah, that's true. It was nice to see them be able to get some work as well. Why do you think at first, I mean, I don't know if you know this, but why it seemed Vince McMahon, the owner of WWE, seemed to kind of shun the movie, and now all of a sudden, I guess near the end, he seemed to embrace it a little bit more and was willing to talk about it?
I think because it's the first movie that's really came that close to showing what the business is really like, and it showed it, you know, when you're climbing up that ladder and stuff, you know, it's not all that glamorous, so maybe he didn't want people seeing that part of it, or I don't know, or seeing, you know, the real nitty-gritty, you know, political cutthroat part of the business that really does exist. Nope. So once it got a lot of press and a lot of positive publicity, then all of a sudden it seemed like he just wanted to hop on the bandwagon and try and capitalize on it, you know.
That's true. That does sound like something he probably would do. What was it like having him as an employer?
Well, you know, Vince is a businessman. If you can make him some money, you'll be his best friend. And if not, he won't know you. It's as simple as that.
That's true. And what was the highest, I guess, that you reached in WWE? I know I read somewhere that you had done some Sunday Night Heat, and I guess you were big in the cruiserweight division at the time, or lightweight division.
Well, I had the light heavyweight title for a short time, and then after that, it just slowly went downhill.
Yeah. Well, I mean, is it one of those things, is it a lot of politics involved? Is it who talks to Vince McMahon last kind of thing? I mean, because everyone can have somewhat equal talent, but it seems like some of it is politics and who he knows.
Well, any company that, you know, takes the steps of becoming big and starts getting on TV and starts doing pay-per-views, the politics always start kicking in. But there, I think it was just, you know, it was a part politics and part bad timing, because shortly after I got there is when they bought out WCW, and now they had twice as many guys they needed, and a lot of guys who were already pushed as big superstars. And so when I got hurt and needed knee surgery, you know, my number was up. We're like a bunch of toys. When this toy's broken, bring on the new toy.
Wow, that's an excellent analogy. And since we're going to be running out of time in a few moments, I certainly want to talk a little more about Ring of Honor. Ring of Honor has really kind of improved over the years as far as like national attention. Recently, Ric Flair was involved. I'm not sure if he still is involved or not. My speculation is that for next Monday, they're going to try and use him as the GM for Raw, but I could be wrong. But what is like working for Ring of Honor versus all these other companies? Seems like they're willing to take more input from probably guys.
Oh yeah, they're always open to ideas from the boys, and it's just you know, the politics haven't really come into play. Who knows if they will if something really big happens, but it's more about, you know, it's hopefully, you know, it'll stay a team effort where everyone wants everyone to go out there and try hard and do a great job and not, you know, want to turn into a backstabbing game.
Exactly. And real quickly, can you tell everyone how they can learn more information about Ring of Honor? I know it's on pay-per-view, but do you have a website, anything where the audience can check it out?
Oh, it's at ROHWrestling.com is the website, and they're on HDNet on Saturday nights at in a couple different time slots.
Great, everybody. Nice round of applause for Jerry Lynn. Awesome guest. Thanks so much for giving us a call. Have a great night, and enjoy the rest of the date night.
All right. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.